Shalom, Rastafari. I am Alon Kone Tafari. Now, I'm going to warn all Andai who seek to be true and faithful to the ways of His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie, and His Christ, Jesus. Remember the interview where His Majesty says, I have met certain Rastafari, therefore calling Nainai by a new name. I have met certain Rastafari, and I have told them clearly that I am a man, and that I will be replaced by the oncoming generations, and to never make the mistake of assume or pretend that man is emanated from a deity. It is extremely important to accept the humanity of Christ Jesus and our God and Father Haile Selassie. You see, every other spirit, try every spirit. In fact, you'll learn a lot from evil spirits. But don't follow those spirits. So when you're doing research and investigating, you're going to bump into a lot of accurate information that's going to in some way mislead or debunk scripture. Now, don't stay strong, stay firm, stand straight, erect, you know, as a pillar tuja, everlasting, right? The reason I say this is because I don't want any of the brethren and sistren to be misled and guided into evil ways, because I sense a trick of that evil spirit of the Antichristos coming on. Since they can't do nothing about it, about the truth of His Majesty, what they're going to do is they're going to agree with thine adversary before I and I take them to the judges, right? To judge. And so, I've been noticing a lot of very, very, like, once hidden, now revealed information being released, and some very accurate and astonishing information regarding the heavens and related matters. And coincidentally enough, along with that information is a complement of scripture, complementing scripture and acknowledging scripture to be vital, important, true, factual, but with the condition not to take it literally. If you reject the humanity of Christ Jesus, you reject not only the spirit, you reject our God and Father, and you will be led astray. Do not fall for these tricks. The only thing left for the evil spirit to do is guide you into another direction that is not the way, that is not Jesus Christos. And I felt it extremely important that I announce it to all the brethren and sistren. Because, you see, no matter how much information and how accurate and how advanced and interesting it seems, if you don't have the humanity to put it into play, there's just nothing I and I can do with it. You can digest it, you can learn it, you can regurgitate it, you could do whatever it is thou wilt, but without the official will of that which created I and I, you are left as a vessel at sea, like out, just lost, like a fleeting illusion in which I and I is in pursuit and never will obtain. You see, because I and I need someone to steer our vessel, to direct I and I. And all of these philosophies, and which are interestingly very true, but the fact that they reject the humanity of I and I, God and Father, and His Son, makes it devilish, slanderers, liars like their father. And so let's not fall victims to this. His Imperial Majesty clearly said, the exemplary life of Jesus Christos, which all man must do his best to assimilate, to, you know, to copy, to try to reproduce it, to try to do one's best to live as close as possible to that exemplary life. Without that, we are left lost. Remember that we are a vessel, we are a tool for Jah, and we must understand that it is to Jah which we must bow our heads, you know, like the bow of a ship, and let I and I be guided and be driven the right way. If not, we'll be driven into disaster, a disastrous crash. And I've just had to warn all of the eyes that the evil spirit is, its main concern is okay, it can't deny our God and Father, so it's gonna, or at least it can't deny our God and Father's scripture, the word, one of the three testimonies. And so they're gonna try to exclude the testimony of the Son and the testimony of the Father. So keep that in mind. Shalom. Thank you. May Jah guide and protect thine eye.